Now, apparently, according to Facebook, or at least as it's being reported according to Facebook, that canning is a form of extremism. Now, there's a screenshot, and it's basically like saying, hey, you're getting this message because you're linked to a group that has extremism in it. And so I'm assuming that this is a little more nuanced than what a lot of people think. They think the canning aspect is extremism. I'm doubting that's really it, because there's a lot of old people that are part of canning groups, you know, old ladies that do this all the time, selling their, you know, their jams and stuff. So I really doubt that's what's considered extremism to Facebook. If it is, that's really sad. What I'm assuming is the case here is that maybe there was a few people that are linked to an extremist group, or they are linked to another Facebook page that has a lot of extremists on it, or something like that. And it's probably something really small and silly, but somehow it has linked to this to get warnings. And you can kind of see, like, okay, a canning group might also attract a lot of extremists. Maybe not the most threatening extremists. I mean, you're not going to find a lot of white supremacists or black supremacists or anything like that really probably on there too much, at least not their spew. But you might find some preppers that are really extremists in the sense that, you know, the sky is falling kind of thing. Prepare, prepare. And people that would be with lots of firearms, which really isn't extreme, but a lot of people, like on the left, tend to think if you got a lot of firearms, you must be extremist. So that might be part of it, because a lot of people with a lot of firearms are also preppers, and preppers also can. So therefore, that's probably why there is this warning that's being given out about, you know, extremism when it comes to this canning group. So at least I'm assuming. Again, I could be wrong. It could be that Facebook has just simply declared that canning is, you know, an extremist thing. And I find that kind of hard. I don't even think Facebook would really get that extreme, because in a way that would make them even more extremist themselves for the left. And don't get me wrong, a lot of, if you look at what how Facebook and Twitter and YouTube to a lesser extent have been acting towards the right, I would probably classify them as an extremist, but not in the sense that, you know, they're threatening extremists. There's extremists, you know, wanting to silence anybody who disagrees with them. But anyway, so that's kind of like my take on what's going on with this silly canning thing. Now, I don't can myself. I actually wanted to start canning, and maybe I would have found my way to this group and become an extremist. Oh my gosh, I just realized I look like that laughing gif for that on Twitter. I can't. It's part of probably one of the movies, but you know, he's like kind of thing. So I think I just mimicked that and didn't even realize it. I'm not going to try and explain that anymore. That's kind of stupid. But anyway, so yeah, so Facebook is sending out the most strangest message. And again, they don't give any details really exactly why they're saying these things. So it leaves everybody able to just simply, oh, I guess it might be for this reason or that reason, you know, which is one of the problems with, you know, these kind of organizations. They ban people, they send out stupid messages and stuff, and they don't give any details. And I think that would be a great idea. Maybe we should make, you know, people want to get, you know, all these social medias under control. Maybe one solution too to really help is make it where they have to say, you're being banned. We're saying this because of that. You know, we're saying there's extremism. This is the reason. So they have to be specific, kind of thing. At least with the bands, I think that would be very helpful. They would have to be specific. Why is it banned? Why is it in violation of terms of service? And I think that would actually solve a lot of problems, because one, it holds Facebook accountable, and two, everybody can actually know how people have been violated and banned for what. Because most people are just like always worried. What did they say to get banned? Could I be guilty of that? And I've never seen anything wrong there. But I think we ultimately know most of that time these random bands that make no sense, where they come back and go, it was an accident because of all the hoopla. You know it wasn't an accident. They just thought they would get away with it. Because, how do you accidentally, Facebook and Twitter, accidentally ban somebody without any warnings? So anyways, I'm going on a tangent there. I thought I'd just put my two cents in on this canning ban or canning extremist thing. It's just silly.